There you see Yankee Stadium, the second ever New Era Pinstripe Bowl. And of course, it's the Big Ten rematch showdown. Michigan taking on Nebraska in this first round of the BCS playoffs. These two teams met earlier in the year. Michigan dominated 45-17. What in the world is going to happen this time around as we bring you day two of the Bowl Championship Series playoffs here? And this one is actually in Stanford bracket number four, and we didn't even get to that bracket last night. Didn't even touch it. The Stanford bracket, which of course Stanford, Notre Dame, Michigan, Nebraska, Oregon, BYU, and Houston, or no, Baylor, Southern Miss, pardon me. And winner of this game, they'll move on to either play Notre Dame or Stanford in the second round. And we're actually going to find out who's going to be playing in that game tomorrow night. That'll be tomorrow at 8, Saturday, December 17th. Still have coming up, well, actually going on right now, is the Arnell Carriers New Orleans Bowl. Now you see Denard Robinson, of course, the workhorse of this team. That's got number one LSU going at it. We got, of course, the Idaho Potato Bowl, Oregon, to compete in that against BYU, Little Caesars Pizza Bowl, which will have Wisconsin. Another NIT game. These NIT games have been thrilling. The Armed Forces Bowl, that'll have number three, Oklahoma State. And then the Las Vegas Bowl tonight at 9 between Boise and FSU, the rematch from last season. We're underway. The New Era Pinstripe Bowl. New York City Yankee Stadium. Last year we saw Michigan State give up a 17-point lead to Hawaii in this bowl game. What will Michigan do in this bowl game this year? The Wolverines and the Cornhuskers. Denard Robinson opening play. They're going to pitch it out. And Fitzgerald Toussaint, of course. I mean, this young man, Fitzgerald, has really, really turned it up this season. He's just been all over the place. And they're going to lose a yard on that little run. Michigan Wolverines coming to this one ranked number 13. Nebraska at number 20. Denard Robinson in shotgun on 3rd and 7. Robinson has his man. That's going to be a Michigan Wolverine first down. He is able to find Vincent Smith, the running back. One of the running backs. He plays just behind Fitzgerald Toussaint. And he's out there catching passes. Vincent Smith, that's his 11th grab of the year. He's got 2 touchdowns on the year. 1st and 10, brand new day. Yesterday was fun, but we got a brand new day of games here today, Friday. And then tomorrow will be Saturday. And that's when really college football gets going, is football games on Saturday. Denard Robinson pitches it to Fitzgerald Toussaint. Toussaint's able to get 3, so little by little they're able to move the ball nearly at midfield. Yankee Stadium. We saw yesterday, the very first game of the day was in a baseball stadium at Tropicana Field. Now we got Yankee Stadium for the Rays, the Yankees. And we also saw the Military Bowl over at RFK. That was at the Nationals, so all the baseball parks getting some dap here. And Fitzgerald Toussaint with the run, and he's able to get the Michigan Wolverine first down. Wolverines are moving the ball at ease on this first drive. They have the ball at the 35-yard line. We had some movement, no flag. Robinson screens it out for a 9-yard pickup. Junior Hemingway, the senior. Michigan Wolverine, it's been a while since we've seen them in the BCS playoffs, but they're back and they're going up against Big Ten foe Nebraska. Nebraska was in the Final Four last year. They upset Oregon, undefeated Oregon, in the Holiday Bowl. They went on to take out the Oklahoma Sooners in the Rose Bowl, and they made it to the Final Four where they were eventually eliminated. And now they move up to the Big Ten here this season. Toussaint with another good run, 7 yards. He's already looking like he wants that player of the game nominee. Rolling out. Robinson. He takes off. Down goes Denard Robinson, of course, player of the game. Also receives an MVP trophy. So these players, they want to collect the hardware and be MVPs, of course. So Robinson didn't have anything there. Decided to take off, and he was tackled into the turf by Brandon Chatpeak, offensive lineman. Or was that Will Compton? Yeah, it had to have been Will Compton. Chatpeak's on the offensive line. That was Will Compton who got the tackle. The linebacker. They'll bring it 3rd down and 3 for Michigan. Robinson, he will roll out, bat it away, incomplete. So Denard Robinson will have to head to the sideline unless Brady Hoke is so inclined to go for it. He is not, and Michigan will attempt the field goal. That one will be a field goal from Gibbons. Kick is good. Gibbons knocks it through from 34 yards out, and Michigan Wolverines, nice opening drive, is able to put 3 on the board against the Huskers. It is Nebraska time. Taylor Martinez, he has thrown for 1,973 yards, so he is all but assured to hit 2,000 yards in this game. 12 touchdowns, 7 interceptions on the year. But you saw the man that run it back, Rex Burkhead, with his 1,000 rushing yards on the year and 15 touchdowns. Burkhead took that run for 5 yards. 2nd down and 5. Ball at the 27-yard line. Burkhead takes it again. He's hammered down. He goes. 3rd down and 7, loss of 2 yards. The frustration starting to show from Mr. Rex. The other thing now, passing situation on 3rd and 7 for Martinez. No, it's not. They're going to inside hand it off. And Burkhead's only going to get 3 on the carry. And that's going to be 3 and out for the Huskers. Michigan defense holds. They let Burkhead run it 3 straight times. Can't give him the first down. And they're going to give it right back to Denard Robinson, that high-powered Michigan offense. And that's probably why Michigan won that first game 45-17 earlier this year. We say earlier this year, it's actually just 4 weeks ago. Those two met up. Brady Hoke, first year head coach. What a job he's done with this 10-2 Michigan Wolverine team. Fitzgerald Toussaint runs the ball, gets the first down. Michigan rolling again. They're just past midfield into Husker territory. Robinson's going to throw it out to the fullback, and he's going to lose a yard. Those fullback, John McLaughlin. Second and 11. Robinson to throw. Into the hands of his receiver. First down. Junior Hemingway once again. Robinson just hits Hemingway. The new era Pinstripe Bowl. Yankee Stadium. A cold, frigid day in New York. But Michigan can handle it. That's why they chose this bowl at... They had, of course, pick number 13, so they didn't have that many bowls to pick from, but I'm sure they're fine heading over to New York. They got to see so many cool things while they are here enjoying their week of vacation that, of course, Bill Hancock loves to talk about, and we still have that here in the BCS playoffs, the Bowl Championship Series. This is a true Bowl Championship Series. Denard, he ran it, and then he saw big number 51, Will Compton looking at him, and Robinson said, no thank you, I'll just go ahead and slide down. I'm not going to take that hit from Compton. should be the final play of the first quarter. And down goes Denard Robinson. He is going to get sacked. Sacked by number 34. And, of course, that's defensive end Cameron Meredith from Huntington Beach. So I'm sure this is quite a weather shocker playing in this cold weather. But I'm sure he's used to it playing in Nebraska. That's the end of the first. And it is 3-0. The Michigan Wolverines over the Nebraska Cornhuskers here at the New Era Pinstripe Bowl. Yankee Stadium, we're jam-packed. Look at this. Fans, they came out for this one. Fans not only of Michigan football, but also Nebraska football, but also just fans in the New York area that are just plain fans of football. That punt will go into the end zone, and Taylor Martinez and the Huskers will get another shot at it in their only other drive of the game. They went three and out on three straight runs to Rex Burkhead. See what Fellini does this time around. They switch it up. This time didn't give it to Burkhead, but not much better on the run. Brings up a second down and 8 for the Huskers. Martinez, they're finally going to let him throw. He rolls out, and that's going to go incomplete. Nebraska last year, they took down the WAC champions in the first round of the BCS playoffs. 56 points, the most points scored in any game. Last season, they took down Nevada, and then they went to roll on to do battle with undefeated Oregon, took them out, the Pac-10 champs. And that was a first down for the Huskers. They then rolled out and took down Big 12 champions. Oklahoma, they beat three champions on their way to the Final Four before finally getting eliminated themselves. And Pelini and staff, they're trying to make another run here. Trailing by 3 in the early going of the Pinstripe Bowl. Martinez will take off. Martinez will be hit after gaining a yard. Brings up second down and 9 from the 45-yard line. Martinez in the gun. Stacking the line. Has his man, and that'll be a 8-yard gain. I apologize for not getting any names to you. They're moving so quick on the no huddle, it's hard for me to get a number and who caught the ball. Inside hand up to Burkhead. Burkhead breaks the tackle, but that's all he's going to break. And Michigan, they're going to break his face because they take him and throw him down. And what started off as a really good drive will lead to Nebraska having to punt the ball away. And it just rolls into the end zone. And that's where the Michigan Wolverines will take over. First down and 10. Robinson with 5 wide receivers. Going deep. Single coverage. That one is caught at the 35-yard line for the Michigan Wolverines. How about the poise from Denard Robinson to find his receiver? That Odoms, I believe, that got it. I think that was Odoms, number 9. First and 10 now for Robinson. Another open man inside the 15. Denard Robinson, 2 incompletions. He is over 100 yards throwing. They quickly move to the 14-yard line. They go to Fitzgerald Toussaint. Toussaint breaking free. He gets in for a 7-yard pickup. They're down. I think they're inside the goal now. They're at the 8-yard. No, they're at the 7-yard line. Denard, low snap. Oh, he should run it. No, he's going to throw it. Just shy of the first down. That was the Toussaint. Third down and 1. Let's see what Hoke is going to do. They're going to line up in shotgun. Does Denard run it? Do they give it to Toussaint? Denard's going to throw it. Denard is going to run it. And Denard Robinson, touchdown, Michigan Wolverines. 9-0. Wolverines take the lead. Just drops back. You have the gap. Go ahead and take it. In the corners, the linebackers didn't even see it coming. Touchdown, Denard Robinson. Here comes the point after attempt. And the Wolverines, they lead 10-0 over the Cornhuskers. Five plays, 80 yards, ate up about a minute of the clock. And you see the flag runners, go big blue. 2:30 left on the clock for Nebraska with all three timeouts. On their first drive, they did nothing with the ball. On their second drive, they made adjustments and they moved to about the 50 before they were stopped. Now, let's see if Nebraska can make a couple of more adjustments in order to get even further down the field. But Martinez, play action, fakes it to Burkhead. He tried to option out, and the Wolverines were not fooled at all. It was Courtney Avery who was in on the tackle along with JT Floyd. It'll be a second down and 15 for Nebraska in shotgun. Burkhead takes it. Burkhead bounced it off. There he goes to the 40. Finally brought down at midfield, Rex Burkhead with his biggest run of the game. An automatic first down here for the Huskers, and now they are at midfield. Martinez, he wants to do some running. He can't get past his own lineman. There he goes. I've never seen anything like that. He could have gone for so much more for the offensive line. They didn't push. They held up the wall. Martinez couldn't get past him. First and second and one. They give it to Burkhead. Burkhead gets the first down past the 30. No huddle. Maybe that's something they need to go to, Nebraska, this no huddle, because it's working well against this Michigan defense. Rex Burkhead has it again. He gets tackled. Second down and 8. They have the ball at the 26-yard line. Taylor Martinez out of the gun. Send some guys in motion. They will have three wide outs. Martinez finally snaps it. Burkhead takes it. Burkhead hurdles. Third down and 6 now for the Huskers. It's been a really good drive for them. Play action. And as soon as we say that, they have a miserable ending to the drive. Linebacker Kenny Demas from Oak Park, Michigan, the junior, is able to get in there and take down Taylor Martinez. And did that take him out of field goal range? We wait and see. It didn't. They're going to attempt the long one, be about 40 plus. With the man kicking it is Brett Mahler, and from 40 plus yards out, he is 4-for-4 on the year. In fact, he's only missed 3 field goals all year, and they've been from the 50 plus yard range, so he's been really good this season. Can he make it 5-for-5? They will, yes. There's Hayreb. Nebraska is on the board, and we avoid yet another shutout here in the BCS playoffs. We haven't had one yet, and I think that we've had a couple of blowouts, but I think you should look at the fact that we haven't had a single shutout yet, and that's a credit to these players wanting to put points on the board and try to do whatever they can here in this bowl championship series playoff season. Just 18 seconds left to go, but with 3 timeouts, that's lots of time for Denard Robinson to do something deadly. They decide, though, Brady Hoke, Fitzgerald, Toussaint, let's get out of this. Well, no, they take the timeout. Now they're going to go 5 wide. Interesting. You run the ball, try to get them to rest on their morals. Robinson avoids the sack. Robinson steps up, and he can't find anybody. He does finally go down. They use their second timeout and maybe try to channel some of Michigan State, trying to go deep here at the end of the half. Low snap, Robinson avoids one, can't avoid the other. That's another sack onto Denard Robinson. Nebraska calls the timeout, and they want the ball back. This is a little bit of a timeout chess game. You can't take them with you to the second half. Might as well use them. Let's see if we can get a big return. We cannot, and we are going into the half. Nice defensive battle with a couple of nice moments of offenses on both sides. It's Nebraska 3 and Michigan 10. And we head into the locker room as the number 13 team in the nation leads number 20. We'll be right back. And welcome back to the second half here in New York, Yankee Stadium on this Friday afternoon. No, it's not baseball season. It's Big Ten football as part of the Bowl Championship Series. And we got some game tracks for you. Robinson and Martinez have been hit hard by defense. That's been about the story in the first half. Some, like we said, some flashes of brilliance in the offensive game, but for the most part, it's been all about the defense, and they've done a really good job of getting to the quarterbacks and hitting them hard, causing some loss of yards. First and 10, Taylor Martinez, inside handoff to Burkhead. And he's going to get 4 on the run. It'll be second and 6 from the 25-yard line. Martinez in the gun. Gets it to the 32, the 30 inches. Winner of this game will either meet Stanford or Notre Dame in the second round. Staying on his feet. That was a really bad attempt at the option. I have no idea who it is. Again, I apologize for the no huddle. It would be nice if our stat thing at the bottom would tell you who ran it, but apparently developers at EA couldn't handle doing that much. We have a flag on the play. It's going to be a face mask. Courtney Avery. That's a bonus yardage. They move up to the 49-yard line. But yeah, on that last play, a really bad option and then bad tackling turned into a first down for the Huskers. And give it to Burkhead again. He's having a hard time getting going right now against Michigan. It's second down and 11. Martinez lines up, hurries up to get into the center. Fumble on the play. I didn't think he had complete possession of that. Let's take a look at the replay. That'll be Michigan football, but I wasn't 100% sure yet. Don't you have to take it? Let's see. He caught it? Did he even take... I don't know. I'm almost inclined to say that might be an incomplete pass. The referees might have missed one because you got to catch it and take at least a football step, and I don't think he did. Well, Michigan, they get advantage of one. Ed Hockley Jr. can't always be perfect. Can Michigan take advantage of perhaps what I think? Maybe you don't think. Maybe Michigan fans don't think, but I think a blown call. Option to Fitzgerald Toussaint. Knocked back for loss of one and just really good defensive play in this game. They say the SEC is the only conference that has any real defense. I challenge you to watch this game and tell me this isn't some really good defense. Robinson just floats it out, pinpoint. How good is Robinson able to get in to double coverage? He was able to get it to Odoms. Still waiting for Roy Roundtree, Kruger, Gallen to get their names here out here today. Haven't done too much today. Third down and 1. Keep your eye on Fitzgerald Toussaint. I formation in the back. No, Robinson's going to throw it. Caught. And we have a flag. A return face mask for Nebraska. It'll set up first and goal for the Michigan Wolverines, and now keep your eyes on Fitzgerald Toussaint. Or maybe Robinson will run it. He is going to run it. Denard Robinson, second touchdown of the day for the Michigan Wolverines. They fool him again. Just really good blocking up front. Robinson took the snap, waited, and there's the run. Michigan leads Nebraska. The Huskers are looking for their first touchdown of the football game. Trying to get this offense going. That's not working either. They got 1 yard. Martinez takes it. Just short of the first down. Not a bad run. And now we'll see if they stick with Burkhead. Give it to him. Let him run up the middle or something to get that 1 yard. Or do they option out? Give it to Rex, and that's going to be a Nebraska first down. Huskers desperately trying to get that first score of the game. Martinez has his man. First down, Huskers. Inside the 40. I wish our stats would come up and pop up at the bottom of the scoreboard and tell you is who catching these things, but maybe they'll add that next year. Martinez, and that's not going to work. Offensive line can't block, and they're just letting the Michigan defense just break in there way too freely. Second and 14. Ball is at the 40-yard line. That was Klein. Now we got it to pop up. I wish it would pop up more often than that. We had some movement. Ed Hockley keeps the flag in the pocket. Ed Hockley Jr. Martinez fumbles it. Michigan football. And that's got to be a touchdown. Yes, it is. All the way to the house. Touchdown, Michigan Wolverines for Avery. Courtney Avery scoops it up. Turnovers leading to points for the Michigan Wolverines. And this is going more so the way you would think that the game plan would have been changed a little bit for Nebraska after the beating that the 42-point beating Michigan gave them earlier this year. Just a couple of weeks ago, that game plan, though, looks like it's remaining the same. Michigan is rolling right now on the Huskers. Denard brings that one back, and here comes the Nebraska offense back onto the field. Rex Burkhead, 4 yard gain. Burkhead takes it again. Burkhead gets the first down, keeps on his feet, and he rolls forward to the 42-yard line. It'll be first down and 10. Martinez in the gun. Play action. Martinez goes down. Not sure what in the world they are trying to do, but it did not work. Quentin Washington was the man that went in on the tackles. That'll make it a second down and long. Martinez, pressure. Martinez steps up and fumbles it again. That's Michigan football. We're going all the way to the other house. Big offensive, defensive lineman. And that's Washington for the touchdown. Quentin Washington, a second fumble recovery for a touchdown. The big man. Martinez fumbles it again. Three in Michigan, starting to pull away. Point after attempt is good. And at this point for Nebraska, it's not looking too well. They got to try to make something happen. Martinez hooks up with his receiver. Good enough for a first down. Three-yard gain on that play. Second and seven. Nothing for Burkhead. This has just been a rough day for him. Has not been able to get the ball rolling. Third down and nine. Nebraska laid a beating on Nevada last year, put up 56. Well, now the team that was in the Final Four just 1 year ago is getting beat on by the Wolverines. That's going to be some positive yardage, at least for the Huskers, as Martinez was able to hook up with Quincy Enua. First and 10, Martinez, nothing. And we head to the fourth quarter. The Michigan Wolverines marching all over Nebraska, and they look like they have a date with either Notre Dame or Stanford in the second round. Michigan over Nebraska, 31-3. At Yankee Stadium, the new era Pinstripe Bowl. It's the second one ever. Last year's Michigan State in Hawaii. This year, Nebraska and Michigan. And once again, Michigan defense, way too tough. Third and 12. This is going to be a team to fear as the weeks roll on here in the playoffs. Martinez overthrows his man, out of bounds. Fourth down and 12. And they're just going to punt it away. Have yet to score a touchdown is the Nebraska Cornhuskers. That one will bounce into the end zone. That's indicative, yeah, of the day they've had. You see the look on the face of the punter. That's just indicative of the kind of day they've had here today. Just things hadn't been going their way. Simple as that. First and 10. They give it to Toussaint. And it's simply a run-out-the-clock situation right now. And just preview what we got coming up next, the famous Idaho Potato Bowl. That'll be between Oregon and BYU. Exciting, high-powered Oregon. Fitzgerald Toussaint breaks free down to the 46. And then, of course, the Little Caesars Pizza Bowl. That'll be between Wisconsin and West Virginia. And then later on, we have the Gildan New Mexico Bowl as part of the NIT. The Bell Helicopter Armed Forces Bowl, that's at 8, and that'll be between the Oklahoma State Cowboys and the Arkansas State Red Wolves. And then the Mako Bowl, Las Vegas, Boise State, and Florida State, the rematch from last year. And then Sunday, we finish it off with the Champ Sports Bowl, Music City Bowl, GoDaddy Bowl, Independence Bowl, Craft Fight Hunger Bowl, Insight Bowl, and the final NIT game, the Christmas Bowl. Second down and 15. Robinson trying to stiff arm a defender, and he's happy with any kind of yards he gets on that run. It'll take us to a third down and 10 with the football at the 47, in between the 47 and 46 yard line. Robinson out of the gun. And trying to let as much time tick away here. As game plan was just there for the Wolverines, and what really killed the Huskers here was the two fumbles that were brought back for touchdowns without a doubt. Was the one that kind of knocked it away. Toussaint with the run and gains a few, but gains no more than that. Fourth down and two. Which we have LSU and Louisiana Tech playing it out right now on the other network on the New Orleans Bowl. I'm sure we're losing quite a few ratings to that game. Everyone's flipping over to see the number one seed, as this one looks to be well in hand for the Michigan Wolverines. Kick is away. And we're going to see if Nebraska can at least get a touchdown out of this game. Martinez lines up in the gun. Martinez will run it. And he will go down. He needs to be careful not to fumble it, though, anymore. He's already fumbled it quite a few times today that have led to 14 Wolverine points. And waiting for his guys, they're kind of just taking their time, shuffling back to the line. There's a run. Martinez will go down again. Martinez just content to try to run in. You see Washington, who got in on the tackle. That big boy, he's already got a touchdown here today. 7 points for him on a fumble return for a touchdown. And Taylor Martinez, this day, this has not gone well for Bo Pelini and his crew. Third down and nine. Finally, we get a first down for Nebraska. Fake to Burkhead. They let Martinez run it. And whatever they're trying to do, that is not working. I mean, Michigan, whether they see it or what, but, I mean, they're blitzing their linebackers and corners. They're just getting through way too easily, and they're getting to the quarterback. Martinez will drop. Martinez will try to run. Bounces off a defender. There he goes. But he's finally ripped down and tackled. And they're going to call a timeout with 1 minute to go. And you can see some of the dirt on the field starting to build up from the Yankee Stadium and some of that brown dirt coming through. And they'll have to punt it away here. Robinson gives it to Toussaint. We just wait for this clock to hit zero. The Wolverines, 31-3. The second time this season, they have thumped and thrashed the Nebraska Cornhuskers. That will do it. Michigan on to round number two. Who will they meet up with? Will it be the Stanford Cardinal? Or will it be the Nebraska Cornhuskers? We will find that out tomorrow night at 8. For now, Michigan, Nebraska. I know it's not going to be a joy for Nebraska, but they'll get to enjoy a couple more days here in New York as a reward for finishing the season in the top 32. There you see what was the play of the game. The fumble return for touchdown by Avery and the fans. Hey, they're excited. And so is first-year head coach Brady Hoke. You can't ask for a better performance from your team in that playoff game. 31-3, Denard Robinson, 154 yards, 2 touchdowns. Now you see the fans that made the trip out to New York for this one. They're excited, and Martinez, him and his Cornhuskers, they made it to the Final Four last year. Wasn't meant to be this year. You see Denard Robinson, he takes it in. This was his second score of the day. How good is this guy, Denard Robinson, this leader of this Michigan Wolverine team? The junior. And I know for Michigan's sake, they're hoping that he won't head on to the NFL. I'm sure he can do some good things for this Michigan team. There you see Washington, the big guy, running it in. 7 points. He'll remember that one forever. Some final screenshots, and we're going to give you some final numbers as we say goodbye and let you guys get ready for our upcoming games, which would be the Idaho Potato Bowl and the Little Caesars Pizza Bowl. So do you want Idaho potatoes or you want Little Caesars pizza? I'll let you decide. Game stats here. Scoring summary, I don't think you need to know anything else, but it was just pure dominance for Michigan just down the line. Taking a look at the player stats, we all know how well this man did, Denard Robinson. Can't ask for a better day than that, a nearly 200 passer rating. On the other side, Martinez, 8 for 11, 74 yards, or 79 yards, didn't do too well. Rex Burkhead, 13 rushes, got it out there for 67 yards, but other than that, he was just held short. Austin Jones got a couple. Fitzgerald Toussaint, though, I mean, what can you say about him? 13 tries, 90 yards, almost broke the 100-yard barrier. On the receiving, Junior Hemingway, always good. Odom did good. Toussaint, Roundtree was in there for a good catch. On the Nebraska side, it was Cotton, Klein. Taking a look at defense to round this thing out, you see the sacks. You see it was Cassidy that had the 10 tackles. That led the team. And on the Michigan side, 1, 2, 3, 4 sacks. You had fumbles all over the place. Finally, team stats on both sides. Let's take a look at it. More first downs for Nebraska, but Michigan, they outclassed them in total yards. Certainly got them here in touchdowns. More passing yards. Third down efficiency, that remained about the same. Red zones, though, 100% efficiency. Huskers, they never even smelled the red zone. 3 turnovers to Michigan, 0. That's a big part of the loss. Other than that, total yards. Nebraska, they clipped them, but it's what matters was on the scoreboard, and you see it right down there, 31-3. That'll do it, folks. We'll see you in just a couple of hours as we roll on here, the BCS.